بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I'd like to make sure that we understand certain basics of the udhiyah. Like some people ask me, should we sacrifice lambs only? Can we sacrifice sheep? It means male and female. The companions of the Prophet ﷺ did both. They sacrificed sheep, they sacrificed lambs. In case you find any shortage in the market to have lamb, it is okay and normal to sacrifice sheep. There is no difference. And the only thing we should take care of is to choose the good animal, not any defected animal that we are going to sacrifice. Defected animals are not accepted for sacrifice. That is one thing. Point number two, some scholars say that in case you want to sacrifice, then you should start not shaving, not doing such and such from the first day of the Hijjah until you sacrifice. This is an opinion of fiqh that is founded on a certain hadith narrated by others than al-Bukhari. Al-Bukhari didn't find any authenticity in that direction. So you need not, I could say, you need not be committed to anything of that, like what a muhrim does in Hajj in order to sacrifice. I myself follow the direction of al-Bukhari that there is nothing authentic enough for that direction. Point number three. It is understood that the most important thing in your udhiyah, in your sacrifice, that you slaughter in order to manifest the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the tawheed. Because it is an Islamic ritual when you slaughter. Meat and eating meat, that is a minor issue. But usually, as the Quran says in Surah Al-Hajj, that when we sacrifice, let us feed the needy and the poor people of what we sacrifice. Any percentage of what you sacrifice that you would eat or you would give is not important. The most important thing that you are advised to give some of what you slaughter to other people who are needy or who are poor. يا أيها الذين آمنوا أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم. When you want to give sadaqah, you should give of what is halal and what is of the best. As the Quran says in another occurrence, لن تنالوا البر حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. You cannot be righteous if you don't give and spend in the cause of Allah of what you like. Don't give leftovers. Instead of throwing in the trash, you give it to needy people. This is not the method or the way of a Muslim would do. أنفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم. طيبات means two things. What is halal and what is good, qualitative. So here we see in sacrifice, again, we are going to choose what is good and what is of value and halal when we sacrifice. وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ. Don't choose what is not good or what is haram. Because khabith has two meanings, bad or haram, or bad and haram. Either or both. And the Quran says, وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ. You won't choose anything bad unless you don't see, you don't know. إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ, it means you close your eyes that you don't know, you don't see. The most important thing in Eid al-Adha, that we slaughter after Salah. And anyone slaughters before Salah, then that cannot be a sacrifice. That be any kind of meat. So you should make salah before you sacrifice. You cannot sacrifice any time earlier.